Well, folks, we can't get rid of the impeachment talk because it's going to be here for a long time. So you better get used to it. Not that I want to discuss it, and we'll probably pass on it sometimes, but it is going to be the focus. This whole Ukrainian thing is blowing up, and there's the good and the bad and the really ugly, and we'll get into some of that this hour. Now, later on, we've got a special guest for you. His name is Frank Salvato. He's from Underground USA, and they're a really cool podcast network that carries the John LeBang Show, as well as other really awesome shows there. So stay tuned for that. That'll be in the second and third segment. Let's get into this, because we have a whistleblower who gets secondhand information that has now made a big, giant, huge media circus where the Democrats are really pushing impeachment and the media's all behind them because that's all they've been doing since they've gotten, or since Trump has gotten into office. But I wanted to pose a question to my listeners, because to me, this is not being asked, and we know why if you're a regular listener to the show, but I want to put this out there. When is it clear that the leaders of the agencies charged with investigating illegal behavior have a vested interest and a clear bias to the destruction of a presidency? And if that is what is happening, are you allowed to investigate that corruption independently as a president? Because that's kind of what's in the forefront here. I'm of the belief that if that is what is going on, that President Trump is trying to do an independent investigation, I don't have much of a problem with it. But I'll tell you, the optics are a little disturbing. And you know, the reporting has been business as usual. And I keep wondering to myself, where were they during the Obama administration? And then you get Adam Schiff grandstanding. He calls it a parody. But I call it making up stuff on national television. But is impeachment even doable? Or is it flimsy? Does it even have any merit? Well, I've looked at the transcripts. And I have my own opinion on what was happening there. This latest episode is starting to show the cracks even in the Republican Party. But is he getting close to something? Is that why we're seeing more and more come at him? And wasn't the Steele dossier exactly what is being called a crime now? This is now what the, I don't know how many leaks have come out of the White House. And you wonder why Trump hasn't done anything to clean house a little bit better. He knows they've been spying on him from the very beginning. Yet he hasn't done a really good job at cleaning house. And every time he wins something, he beats his chest like King Kong. Instead of taking that political capital and moving the ball forward. He gets a first down and then takes a knee. He just jumps around. Yeah, first down. Dude, you got 99 more yards to go, bro. Or at least 90 yards. Because you started behind the end zone. But we got a whistleblower with secondhand information. A Democratic Party that has looked for every single reason they can to get rid of this guy. A media that is complicit in that. We have foreign operatives giving information to the Democrats, and that's okay because they want to investigate Trump. But if Trump wants to, this is my opinion on the transcripts. He was like, hey, bro. Good job winning the election. Congratulations. You know what you should do? You should really check into that corruption that's in your government. because there's a lot over there too. We kind of know that. And check into this, and then check into this guy. He didn't say from any of the transcripts that I can see, and nobody is even claiming this out of outside of Adam Schiff's little grandstanding parody there. He didn't say, dude, listen, you ain't getting crap from us unless you do this. And see that political opponent? I need as much dirt as we can get on this guy. He didn't say that. He said, hey, man, there's corruption in your government. We know about it. You've helped us before in the past, your government has, with information. We're helping you back out. I mean, there is a treaty there. So, there's some corruption in your government. And you might want to look into this over here and this guy. Because there's things going on. And we'll talk about that here in just a moment. Because what I think is going on is projection. You know, it's a common way of deflecting attention away from one's own bad behavior and placing it on another. It's the, I didn't, but I'll accuse you of doing it. Especially when one's actions are being examined under a microscope. And that's what's happening. People wanted the swamp drained. So we wanted to look at everything to get a clear picture. But over there, the ones that project things, just throw charges at people. Just throw charges at someone. Maybe it'll stick. Even without evidence. And continuing until the spotlight is off of them. And that's what we're seeing right now with the Democrats. Here is a party that has engaged in all kinds of criminal behavior. Hell, they anointed the biggest criminal in the history of the world, in my opinion, to be their candidate for president in 2016. I mean, she only destroyed evidence that the FBI was apparently looking for. And you know what did they do? They looked away. They looked away. Laptops, servers, phones, emails, all kinds of things. Just happened to not make the evidence room. And this is all public record. Yet she is still walking free. As much as she can walk, being an old lady. And while she is able to collect large sums of money to speak along with her comrades and have all these accusations continually thrown on Trump, she's making all this money. Doing a speech here, an appearance there. They throw things like collusion, racism, being a meanie for separating children from people who may or may not be their parents. We don't know, but hey, you're the meanie, Mr. Trump. You were the one doing the election meddling, right? But all those are just projections of their own actions. Now we have the phone call gate. The people just had an election. They elected a new leader in the Ukraine. And if you read the transcripts, President Trump congratulated the new president. He was calling him to say, hey, dude, good job. You won. This dude's a young guy. And here's Trump, the most famous man in the world right now. Remember that, folks. He is the most famous man in the world right now. And he didn't do it on his own. No, the entire left wing, the media, the Democrats, all put his name out there. Continually, Trump, Trump, Trump. I mean, they gave him what he wanted. Just remember that. But you can tell in the early part of the conversation that he was just giving advice on where to start to clean up the corruption. And you know that Donald may be one of the authorities on at least trying to clean up the corruption. Because even though much of the corruption hasn't been dealt with, we're clearly seeing that the FBI, the DOJ, the State Department, and now the leaker is a CIA operative. All these people are working against the president. And by extension, the Union of the States. To some people, they would call that the country or the nation. Their projections of Trump has forced them to expose themselves, which means the Department of Homeland Security, including the TSA, the BLM, the DOE, and any other federal agencies, also have moles in them and are working not only against him, but against the people who elected him. Now, you have to remember, Obama had 8 years to place people in key positions throughout governmental agencies. Bush, who also is part of a cabal, had his own 8 years to appoint people in key positions. Prior to that, we had the Clintons and the Bushes. Decades, really, to corrupt the agencies, the federal agencies of our government. I mean, this is decades in the making. And I think they're nervous. And the Ukraine may be a loose string that can unravel the whole thing. You see, they didn't have time to complete that. They were hoping for Hillary to be in office. They could finish all that work out. Their enterprise there could be completed. Now, Trump has to know he cannot count on any of the aforementioned agencies to assist him in exposing the corruption because they have been actively engaging in preventing him to do so. That is, if Trump isn't here to act like he's trying to drain the swamp. But let's assume he's what he claims to be. He's going to have to do everything on his own, and he probably came to that conclusion shortly after being elected. Once the Republicans in the House and the Senate were getting things done, or weren't getting things done, when they could have, they chose to waste 2 years, and then they got unelected. They left office, shifting the power back to the Dems, who know how to get things done, one way or the other. And isn't that what this impeachment is about? Getting the Donald out of the way, one way or another. Now, they've thrown everything at him, and for almost 3 years have been screaming impeachment, and nothing has worked except they're exposing themselves. Even if Trump isn't the real deal, the culprits of corruption are far easier to point out than ever before. The more they project on Trump, it brings another shadowy operative into the light. We've got to take a quick break, folks. When we get back, we're going to talk with our guest, Frank Salvato of Underground USA.